Goddess of Illusions by Chitra Banerjee Dipkarni. This is one of my favorite novels. In this novel, Draupadi known as Panchali, so I will also address Draupadi as a Panchali. Panchali and her twin brother, Dhiri, are born out of sacred fire of King Draupadi. Sage Vyas said that Panchali's worth made the powerful history. Panchali grows up as a royal princess. She learns 64 arts like singing, dancing, poetry, everything. But Panchali seems disinterested in all of these. She wants to learn his brother's art and gaining knowledge about the world. When Panchali comes of age, King Draupadi arranges a magnificent swayamvar for her. In the audience, the five Pandavas are hiding. At last, Arjun wins the contest and takes Panchali as his wife. Inside the hut, Mother Kunti is cooking. One of Pandavas says, "Look, Mom, what we want." She replies, "Whatever it is, share equally about yourselves." In that, Panchali becomes wife of five husbands. But Ved Vyas has an arrangement here. Panchali will be one husband for 1 year, starting from oldest to youngest. She was really not happy with this decision, but she agrees. After marriage, King Bhishma divided the kingdom between cousins, which are Pandavas and Kauravas. Once Duryodhan visits the palace and because of its illusion falls into pool, and then Panchali laughs at Duryodhan and said, "A blind son of a blind father." This becomes the climax in this story, where Duryodhan wants revenge from Panchali and Pandavas. After this, Yudhishthir loses everything, palace, treasury and his wife, in the dice game against Duryodhan and their uncle Shakuni. Then Pandavas are exiled to forest for 12 years. Panchali conceals as a maidservant to the queen. The queen's brother, Prince Kichak, tries to seduce Panchali. When she shows no interest, he threatens to rape her. Panchali tells everything to his husband, that is Bhim. Then Bhim kills Kichak. As a result of this violence, the Kauravas come to know and whereabout of Pandavas, and the great war of Mahabharata breaks out between the Pandavas and the Kauravas in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. After war, Kauravas dies and Pandavas rule peacefully. In the end of this novel, after hearing of Krishna's death, Panchali's husband decided that it's time for them to die too. Panchali and Krishna shared a beautiful relationship. So the five husband and Panchali ascend towards to the mountains. Their afterlife is shown, Panchali finally unites with Karna in heaven. Let me tell you guys, in the real Mahabharata, nothing shows like that. Only the Palace of Illusions shows that she won't unites with Karna with first interest in heaven.